Meanwhile, the U.S. says the sanctions on Iran could only be lifted if Tehran returns to compliance with the 2015 nuclear deal known as the Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action. White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki said that there has been some progress in the JCPOA revival talks between Iran and the world powers. She said, though, it's a good sign that negotiations are continuing. Meanwhile, Tehran insists that the U.S. first needs to remove all sanctions imposed, reimposed, or relabeled following Washington's withdrawal from the JCPOA. Iran says it will only return to compliance after effective removal of sanctions is verified by the Islamic Republic. And now we're joined out of Irvine, California, by Professor Alexander Alzadegan, senior geopolitical analyst. Hello, Professor. Always a pleasure to have you on Press TV. It's been a while, actually. Hope you're safe and sound out there. Alexander, if I could ask you, I mean, we get these, tidbits of information that there's a lot of progress being made in the talks, but ultimately we're still at this impasse where the U.S. says Iran has to act first and get back into full compliance. We're willing to do a lot once that we see that. Iran is saying, look, we only want all the sanctions, reimposed and relabeled, removed. We also want time to verify that they've actually been removed and that things are back to working business as usual. So basically, we're getting like mixed signals. What I'm basically trying to say, from your perspective, what juncture are we at right now?
Very early. Good morning to you, Daniel. It's always good to be with our audience. This is so complicated, but I have to put it, in a few minutes. The entire logical apparatus of the JCPOA was really not just it was part of JCPOA, but not just the U.S. It's really the Atlantic alliances, stick and carrot policy. And, their talk about their suggestion that, Iran's new generation of centrifuges, that being the IR-4, IR-6, and IR-9, let's just talk them away, right? That's the attitude now. Because last time around, Iran shut down its heavy water reactors in Iraq, and that was to the dismay of millions of Iranians once they found out the details of the JCPOA. The problem with the carrot and stick rule or policy is that you're actually presuming that you're sitting on top of a donkey, which is one of the most least intelligent animals. This is not the case with Iran. Iranian people are very intelligent. The Iranian system has been very flexible with this. And it was exactly 3 years ago that, literally exactly 3 years ago, that Trump's violation of and reneging of the JCPOA happened in May of 2018. Their goal back then, as is now, is to paralyze Iran's energy and banking sector, which would foment into mass protests in Iran, which could result in social, political, and economic chaos, which would in turn manifest in regime change. This is what they wanted all along. The JCPOA was just an excuse. In other words, the Transatlantic Alliance is trying to implement the Libyan regime change model. This is exactly what they're doing. According to the Article 26 of the JCPOA, it specifically allows Iran the right to suspend its contractual commitments in case of non-compliance, in this case, Washington and its arm twisting of many other nations in the world that want to maintain some kind of an economic ties with Iran. Sanctions and in their entirety was enshrined and envisioned in the 159 pages that it will never be lifted as long as Iran wants to remain independent, as long as it wants to be a non-conforming country. The Transatlantic Alliance doesn't want independent countries. It wants vassal states. It wants client states that fall in line and obey and adapt whatever is imposed on them. But the world condition, Daniel, in 2001 is very different than on July 14, 2015, when JCPOA was signed. We are at the threshold of a new Cold War between the West versus China and Russia. In this sense, Iran may benefit a little from the geopolitical tensions and the JCPOA, or what's left of it. And this is at the center stage of this global conundrum. We are no longer looking at P5 plus one. In reality, it's just P3, UK, France, and Germany. I think the Russo-Chinese posturing toward Iran is now very different from 2015. You have the 25-year accord between Iran and China, plus the 20-year accord between Iran and Russia. And as far as the Vienna talks are concerned, in my opinion, it's nothing more than window dressing, you know, taking into consideration the upcoming presidential elections in Iran on June 18th of this year, and the differences of opinion between the Iranian conservatives and the Iranian liberals in the context of the direction of not just the JCPOA, but Iran's role in the region and even at the global level.
So basically, the way you see it, the JCPOA, even if it is revived, it's not really in Iran's benefit. It's basically a cold setup altogether.
Yes, I don't think the JCPOA is revived at all. This is just political posturing. We talked about this in our last interview between
sure
you
did.
And I, that yes, that this whole posturing, this whole thawing of these three countries with Iran and the fact that it's being held in Vienna is an attempt to interfere in Iranian presidential elections in order to somehow create a perception that they're willing to work with the Iranian liberals, the doves, because if the hawks get into power, things will be quite different in the region and when it comes to JCPOA. So it's just, I mean, if Iran has been extremely flexible with this, but its partners haven't. Its so-called partners in the JCPOA haven't. China and Russia are sitting back and observing the whole thing. We now know from the leaked tapes between, well, I'm not going to go into that as an internal Iranian issue, but we now know how Russia was against the JCPOA that was signed in 2015. And I think this time around, like I said, the conflict between Washington and China and Washington and Russia is going to perhaps give some flexibility and support to Iran, at least when it comes to China and Russia. But the rest of it, I think, is a signal from the Europeans that, look, we are going to create this perception that things are going to work out. We may even lift some of the sanctions. We may even allow Dr. Zarif to come to the UN and be present there and not be imprisoned, you know, in the Iranian, delegatory housing, whatever it is, in New York, just to create a perception that something is being done, that the Iranian liberals are winning, that there is a common agreement between us and the current leadership in the Iranian executive branch. But ultimately, I think this is going to fall on deaf ears, at least when it comes to the Iranian population and the Iranian electorate.
Thanks, bud. Stay safe. So it was a pleasure to have you on and hear from you. From Irvine, California, Alexander Alzadegan, Senior Geopolitical Analyst.